Om Namah Shivaya children. In the previous video of HTML, we have learned how we can use different tags to write text in the web browser in different formats, different fonts in different ways. So we shall be continuing with few other ways of how we can like write the text in different ways. So the first one that we will do today is typewriter text element. So typewriter text element uses the tag TT within angular brackets. It is a container element, that is, it has got both open tag, that is TT, and closing tag, that will be backslash TT. What the work of it is, the text enclosed within should be displayed in fixed length typewriter font. Now fixed length typewriter font means, it means basically fixed width or non-proportional font where the letters and characters occupy the same amount of horizontal space. So it is basically used in computer coding where it will be a fixed length, the horizontal spaces of the characters and letters are same. If I write it in the code and run it, you will be better understanding it. But before that, let us read big and small elements. So big, as the name suggests, it is the tag which is used to write the text to be displayed in a larger font. And small, you write it with the tag small, that is also written within angular brackets. It is specified, it specifies the text to be displayed in a smaller font. Now these are also container elements, that is the text that you enclose within the tags big and within the tags small will appear in that certain manner. You can see these examples also, but I will show you by running by writing the code and showing you by typing it itself and seeing it in the web browser. So I've opened the notepad in order to write the codes. Right, like initially I'm writing HTML just to begin with the code. You can skip this as well, but I'm writing it, no problem, because this is a standard method, so I don't want to skip it. So then you might write a title also, text format. I'm just writing a simple title. And then you begin the body of the page. Now let us type. I will only type the thing to show you the typewriter. First writing TT. Within TT, let me write something. I'm just giving a space so that you understand. Or let me just remove the space. Okay. Within the TT tag, you write, say, learning type writer text. Enclose it with backslash TT. Next, let us learn big. Text format. Okay, now let us see small. Small I'm writing formatting text is easy. I'm just trying to see how the design works. Okay, so three tags you can see, the TT, big, small. Let us just save in the same place where we have been saving in documents under class 10 HTML, this folder, if you remember, right? So all files, name the text as text.html, both works, I hope you know that, children. So HTML I'm writing, all files, select all files and just save it. Minimize this notepad one. open the documents. My page is already open. So by default it is supposed to open with Explorer. I'm selecting, right clicking and selecting the Google Chrome to view it. I prefer Google Chrome, that's why. So if you see, I did not put the break for the next line, that's why everything is coming in the same line. But if you see, this particular thing is the TT. This was written within the TT tag, learning typewriter text, right? So this is the TT tag. And text format, this is the smaller one. The big was written in text format, and small was, you can see, formatting text is easy. So you can see in the three different ways by which you can make the text appear in your web browser. I've just written few words, you can write few paragraphs in different styles. So I've just shown you three styles over here. I hope it is clear to you, children. Now the next one is logical elements. Now logical elements also is used to write text in a certain way. As you can see, if I read over here, these elements are used to define the structural importance of the text. That is, every text when you write in a web browser or in a computer, every text has got a meaning, and there's a way of writing different text. So the structural importance of the text, that what text you will write, how, so that is basically used to define with by the type of text you write. So how you will write it, you'll write it with the help of few tags. So those tags will be learning under logical elements. Now one important thing about logical elements is these are browser dependent. Browser dependent means this particular tags might work in one browser, might not work in some other browser. So Google Chrome basically supports all the type of logical elements, because of which I was not working with Explorer, because Explorer sometimes does not support all kind of logical elements. Hence it is told it is a browser dependent one. So these are the two prime characteristics of logical elements. The first logical element is emphasize, used by the tag EM. Okay, it is also a container element, and anything you write within the EM tags will be displayed in italics in the web page. Then is strong. Strong tag is used to highlight the text in the web page. Naturally, whenever you are highlighting, your main intention is to strongly emphasize the word. Whenever you wish to strongly emphasize some word or a heading for a web page, or while designing the web page, you might use the tag strong. So let us emphasize strong in the web page and run and see how it works. I am doing the work in the same web page, in the same page that I designed. We have already done TT, big, small. Now we will be doing EM. Let's write EM. Let's highlight EM. Let me say that. Learning logical elements. Okay. Now let me do one thing, children. You already know, we will do later also, but I am giving BR tag basically gives one break of a line. If I don't give this, no children, you, it will be difficult for you to understand each of the line. That's why I am giving this BR tag. You will also learn it as we proceed through the videos, the other videos also. BR tag we have not done yet in the book, but still I am showing you, because without the BR tag it's getting very clumsy. Next is strong. So strong is okay. Emphasize will let me write strong here. You'll see the same thing I'm writing here. One in strong, one in emphasize. Just see the difference. I'm giving break also so that you can see. You save it. No need to go to save as, because I already the page is saved in the proper format. So just open the browser, refresh it, you'll see the changes come. Since I gave the BR tag, all is coming in next lines. You can see how the texts are written in different formats according to different tags that I've used. Every tag you have to use according to your own way, how you are trying to write a certain paragraph. You have to learn the way, and that's how you will write. Like in EM, it is shown in italics. Sometimes bracketed words are used in italics. So in that case, if you are trying to write anything in brackets, so you can use that. strong is like the bold word. It is used in MS Word, like you can see bold. So that's how the strong is coming. So we have learned what we have learned. We have learned TT, the first one. Then we did the I think we did this one was big. Then we did small, then we did emphasize, and the last one we did today was strong. So these are the five things that we have done in today's video. All of you write this quotes in the copy. Of course, I won't tell you to write the output also in the way that I have written in the output that has come in the web page. So these are the things you're writing in the copy. Okay, give the heading as given in the book. Okay children, all of you write this in the copy, the tag, the code that I've written, and the output is this one. This one is the output. Do write the output in the way that is coming in the web browser. And also you have to underline the words in the book, how I have highlighted, however I have highlighted, wherever I have highlighted, those portions you have to underline in the book. These are the three things that you have to do for by seeing the following video. I hope the topic is clear to you. Next day we will proceed with the other part of logical elements. So till then, Namaste my children.